Ja. Oh, there's Shamim.
Yeah.
What's her, the new, female cub's name?
Nee.
Nee?
Yeah, Nee.
What's the hierarchy with them? So the one you fed first, that'd be the...
Well, it depends very much on the day, but basically, the male, sometimes the males get along fine, but sometimes there are conflicts. And when you have three males, that means you can have two against one. And you can guess who the low man on the totem pole is. Hunter.
Yeah, Hunter took the long way.
Yeah. And the females in the wild, it's the females that do the hunting because they don't have that big mane, and the males stay back and mind all the cubs and protect them. That's their job. When the female brings the kill home, when the females bring it home, it's the male who eats first. If there's not, then everybody gets up. But if there's not a lot, it would be the males and the dominant females right down the line, and the last one to eat would be the youngsters. So if there's a shortage, it's the youngsters who wouldn't get food. And when you think about it, that makes sense, because it's the older ones that have to be able to hunt. And if they said, oh, here, take food first, that wouldn't work. Yes?
Why when Hunter and his sister, why when they were cubs, they were in the smaller one, but now the bigger ones are in the smaller
one? Oh, well, they're just here for eating. When the little ones were here, we had them in here. Yeah, here. Good morning. Any other questions?
How many times a day do they eat?
Once.
Just once?
Yeah, yeah. And there are some days when somebody may eat a lot and somebody may not eat much at all. Yeah. It depends on temperature, activity, all that kind of stuff. All right, I'll take off my gloves and we'll head for the fun part.
Blueberry!
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to have fun.
They're still asleep together.
Anything you would eat besides peanuts, fruit, she loves sweet stuff. And you know those stories of Winnie the Pooh and the honey pot? They've got to be true.
I know that.
Yeah. Now, this is how you're going to feed a bear a peanut. You take it in your pinchy fingers, the way you've been told to never feed an animal. Her nose can't come through, so you have to put it through to her nose. And she takes it very gently. And I'll get this young lady. What's your name? Lily. All right, Lily will show you how to feed. Hey, Lily. Yep. And camera person, you go wherever you need to go. Okay, go ahead, Lily.
I guess what you do.
and she crushes the peanuts and spits out the shells. All right, so we just make a line here. Yeah, and
you listen how to do that?
Oh, yeah.
You don't put your finger through. So you just let them
go. She's really good, yeah. Yeah, you'll. Good job. And come on in. Blueberry makes the rules, everybody. Even the adults, the camera people have to feed. Okay, cameraman, you make her stand up, show them how to do it. Hold it a little bit higher. Well, not that much. Okay. Go ahead, Lily.
Don't pull your finger through.
Perfect. Very good.
Is that cool?
Well
is that
done.
Cool, Lily?
You think Mom should make her stand up? Okay. Mom and Dad wore blouses. If anyone's sensitive to peanuts, I do have peppermint.
Do you have peppermint too?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you must be a bear.
Oh, she finally got a taste for them? Because I remember it was...
Well, she does like them.
Yeah. Because I remember you were saying you couldn't figure out what to feed her when we were here last.
Yeah, well, she... Yeah.
Because Mr. Bear liked peppermint.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Yes. Oh, you're welcome. Come on in.
Is that cool, kiddo?
Yep, well, you all get a turn. Yep, just come on in. And he's taking, yeah, if you're all together, come on in. Okay, well, I'll save that long one. I'll save that long one for a little bit.
Okay.
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, she's going to stand up for you. Yeah, her nose can't come through, so you're good. Oh, you've got your finger. That's okay. If you do something that you're unsure of, you are truly, truly brave.
Oh, I'm sorry. I did it really quick because I was scared.
No.
I didn't think I was
going to because
be
she was run over and her chest was somewhat crushed, we didn't even know if she'd survive initially. And she did have some damage, but she never got to be a really big bear. She's been here 12 years. Yeah. Is that it?
Yeah.
Okay, next. All right, Ricky, and then your group can come after.
You're going to have your picture taken?
Maybe.
Yeah, okay.
No, just the one. Is that cool?
Yeah, you want to stand up, just hold it real high. Excellent. The hard part is taking a picture.
Yeah.
Go ahead. Good job. Okay, next family group, come on right in and stand here, and then you can come up one at a time. Come on in. You can just look at it. You can just look at Blueberry. Blueberry says hello.
I think Blueberry says, give me my peanuts.
Well, Mommy can do it. Yeah.
I think the pugs are on.
Well, Blueberry. Those are dry peanuts. The peanuts are unsalted, but they're very dry. Oh, here. Here we are, Mom. Yeah. Here you are. I've got a big long one if you want to do it. Mom can hold you.
Okay.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Blueberry says thank you. Come on in. Thank you.
fed yet. Come on in. You haven't.
Yeah, she looked like she couldn't stay awake earlier.
Well, I think it's the cool weather. They're all enjoying it. Did you get it okay? Do it again to make her stand up.
Mom,
just hold it. Just hold it a bit higher.
Okay.
That's a good one.
Now you want to check it?
There you are.
I'm not very good at this.
You had the two bears. Control, which one was normally more dominant?
I would say Smokey was the boss.
Yeah.
Basically. But he had a different personality than her.
How was yours? Yeah.
Well, we were at the Shubenacadie while I was
Oh, yeah.
Did yours turn out?
All right.
Yes, it turned out.
Which is the big one.
Oh, it's actually a male.
Cat called a Carico lynx. And if you think of our Canadian lynx is also a small cat but has a much thicker, stockier build. And she's getting the red meat and the unwanted chicken. People who raise chickens get rid of their young roosters because they just want hens or they egg. So they come here and become food. And what do you think she's going to go for? Evidently, they use their ears to signal to each other in tall grass, just like we use our arms. Now, the gibbons next door get their food in the morning. See where that blanket hangs? That's like a door that goes to the inside. And that's where their food is put. So they can go in and out and eat whenever they like, all day long. So I brought them a cracker treat. So you can see them. Yeah. This is Boo, the mom. Boo is 35 years old, which is really old. This is Stormy. Stormy will be 2 in October, and Bobby, yeah, are you coming down, Bobby, for a cracker treat? He's 5. Go on, Bobby. He's way up high. He's like a good kid. He goes to bed early.
There he comes.
Oh, he said it's so hard. There. Oh, and he's going to take his cracker and go right back up to bed. There, Boo. Now, you already noticed that somebody's waiting for a cracker treat. There's Larry, the Japanese macaque. His food is put inside and he eats all day long as well.
Bobby, pick your phone and send it. Daddy, let me see your hands, Bobby.
Thank you very much. Yep, any questions before we head to the cougar? Cougar's over on the other side.
I remember last time we touched his tail and he didn't like
it. Oh well.
Yeah, Jasper's really, really looking forward to that food.
Oh yes.
Yeah.
The meerkats are over there. You'll see them. Well, I've got a little treat for them. So we're going over there now.
I didn't think I was going to see her this time. She's purring.
But see how they're busy making deeper holes because it's getting colder. And as soon as it's cold consistently, then they get moved into the heated barn for the winter. So I think they're enjoying their good size. So, yeah. Around the corner are the Bengal cats.
Jasper was very happy.
And the gate opens in. You're fine right there.
Now, the two little cats who look like house cats are house cats. They're called Bengal cats. And Bengal cats are produced by crossing Bengal leopard cats, which are spotted Asian cats, with domestic cats. And they're sold in the pet trade for a lot of money. These boys live here because in both cases the families that owned them had lifestyles that didn't agree with cats. We were asked if we could take them, give them a home where they could go in and out as they pleased and not have to follow any rules. This guy, our Manny, is showing his age a lot. I brought them some temptation treats.
They have cat food they eat whenever they like.
I know.
Yeah, I have no idea how many domestic crosses are in these boys, but the show bangles, the ones they show at cat shows, have several domestic crosses. See, this guy's in great shape. Our Manny, we're checking out his thing.
He's a cat anymore.
Yeah, he's in decline. Now, Jenga the Bobcat was born at a zoo in Ontario. Came here when he was a few months old. But he is exactly the kind of cat you would see in the wild here if you were out walking and somebody said, "Hey, there goes a bobcat." That's what they're referring to. So what do you think you call that little tail? Now see the spots on the backs of his ears? There is a theory that those spots actually look like eyes that are coming up behind. And the theory is it's a protective pattern. Because if the ambusher thinks it's being watched, it's not left to ambush. And he's definitely going for the tip of the ear. So front to everything. Bones, head. That's how they get the good nutrition. I'll tell you how you tell cat thank you. I needed the dog for it. I'll tell you how you tell cat is comfortable human ears. Some of you have heard this many times. The theory's been around for a long time. A 2-year-old cat is in prime, just like a 24-year-old person. So count 24 human years for the first 2 years of your cat's life. So a 2-year-old cat is like a 24-year-old human. For every year after that, do 4 for the cat. So a 3-year-old cat would be 24 plus 4, which is 28. A 4-year-old cat, add another 4, 32. Jenga is 5. Add another 4, 36. So he'd be like a 36-year-old person. And it makes sense because by the time a cat's mid-teens, it's a senior. So 24 for the first 2 years and 4 for every year after. Anybody, any questions? Pardon? This guy was born at a zoo in Ontario, and they need a home for him. The tigers, everything has been captive bred. The things that do come in as injured are our native wildlife. For example, the eagles are both missing part of a wing. So they were injured in the wild. They went to the vet college. The options were put them down or find a place where they could be looked after. Zar had been born at a zoo in Ontario, came here, 14 years ago, he was 2 months old, and he's been great, and then he lost mobility, so there was something neurological wrong. We tried a couple of things that didn't work. Yeah. So the kind thing is to put them down. He couldn't get up on the stand.
So he was 14 at cat years.
He was 14 regular years.
Regular years.
So 14 in cat. You want me to do the math for you?
Okay.
Okay. So it would be 2 years. Would be 24 plus 12 times 4 is 48 plus 24, 72. So he'd be like a 72-year-old person. And lots of people post cats. I mean, I hear the odd one that lives to 21, but once they get 14, 15, they're getting pretty old. Yeah, and things start to go.
Alrighty.
Okay. We just met Pushka. How old is she now?
She's been here 5 years, I think. 5 or 6. But she came in as a skinny little...
Yeah, she's bigger every time I see her.
I know. And once she had her kitten and then we had her spayed, it's because there's food everywhere. There's so many cats that eat here.
They told us there were 15 cats here. Remember?
I think there are 14 now.
Because Gertrude's gone. He saw his raindrop.
Yes. Yep. And Lawrence, he started to shrink. He's been here probably 14 years. Yeah.
We met her when we first came, she was pregnant.
Oh, yes. Yeah. She's a lovely natured little cat. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
She lived in the house with Toes.
Toes.
Oh, yeah. Toes, the old one.
Yeah.
Yes. Toes has been here forever. Yeah, she spends, she has her favorite spots, but she likes our bedroom very well.
Why not?
Yeah, that's a good spot. You know, yeah. Long